Now that you have set up your Flutter app's UI on FlutterFlow, let's see how you can build the backend functionality of your translation app on Rowy. Rowy is an open-source, low-code platform that lets you build your app's backend. View your Firestore data in spreadsheet-like UI and build Cloud Function with a built-in code editor in your browser. For the translation app, we are going to build three main backend functionalities with Rowy. First, let's store the list of supported languages in your app on Firestore. To do this, let's create a Firestore collection in Rowy called Languages. This is as simple as creating a new table, giving it a name, and then clicking Create. Rowy gives you a collaborative spreadsheet UI for managing your Firestore data. Okay, so let's add the columns. Rowy supports over 30 plus field types. First, we will add a short text column called Language Code, and then another short text column for the language name. Now, let's enrich this data with country flags to give additional visual cues in your app. We can do this with a programmable column type called derivative. This column runs a JavaScript code on any data change to the columns it listens to. So here we are adding a flag code derivative column. We want to listen to any changes in the field language code and very simply split it to get the flag code and store the string. This gets deployed as a cloud function on your own Firebase project. You can right-click to evaluate and see that it gets the code. Then let's get another derivative column that listens to flag code and gets the flag image for that code and from flag CDN URL. You can then store this image in Firebase storage using Rowy utility function, rowy.storage. For ease of use in your Flutter app on FlutterFlow, let's create another derivative column that stores the URL of the image that was stored by accessing the rows flag column array and the download URL. As you can see, we just entered the language code and Rowy was able to automatically populate your database by filling the rest of the column values. We can also import a CSV file with a list of all possible languages in code. And as you can see, Rowy automatically fills up the rest of the column values, giving you a database that populates itself. You can also check the data in Firestore console by clicking the URL here. That takes you to the document directly. As you can see, it is live and available on your Firestore as well. Next, let's create another table collection that stores all the translated text and audio file. So let's add a column for text, then another column for the language, and then a derivative column. Every time a new translation text is added, the cloud function is triggered and uses Google Translate NPM module to translate the text to the selected language. We then add another derivative column that uses Google's text-to-speech NPM module to convert the generated text into an audio file. Let's quickly test by adding a phrase, and there you go. You can see the translation and audio file. Finally, we want some suggested common phrases to show up in the app, so we create another table to maintain this list. We want to automatically generate a translation of these phrases to all the languages in our list. We can do this with an action column that can be used to run a script at the click of a button. Here we have a script that connects the different tables and generates a translation of the phrase for each language and stores it in the translations table. You can explore all of these backend tables along with the code and the Rowy demo linked in the description. As you saw, with Rowy, you can manage your Firestore data as well as write your product's entire backend logic using cloud functions right in the browser without having to worry about configs, boilerplate code, or deploying using CLIs. With the power of FlutterFlow for front-end and Rowy for back-end, you can build and launch any app idea without limits.